Well, greetings, everyone. Once again, this is Yisrayl Hawkins coming to you from the House of Yahweh in Abelin, Texas, and this is the Prophetic Word Show. You know, the prophecies foretold everything that's going on in the world today. The Savior Himself actually prophesied. If you'd get you a pencil and paper, I'll give you some scriptures and show you. But He prophesied these disease epidemics that we're having right now, and He says they're going to get worse, much worse. He prophesied the wars that's going on, the wars in and around the great river Euphrates that is taking place at this time. In fact, Malachi Martin prophesied those. That is, he revealed the plan of the Catholic Church and said, Mary is going to make war with these nations that will not worship her. And of course, meaning worship to them is accept in the Catholic Church and its beliefs and its practices. And of course, the practices of the Catholic Church, is shown in scriptures, will not inherit the kingdom of Yahweh, as we just covered in the last sermon. And write down the scripture, because if you are thinking that you can practice sin and get into the kingdom, and do you know what sin is? Write down 1 Corinthians 6:9-10. 1 Corinthians 6:9-10. Also, write down our address and phone number, and let me show you some scriptures, because the churches, so many of the preachers, I'm so amazed at how scriptural illiterate they are. They don't know the scriptures. They hide behind a mask of praising the Lord and singing songs and stuff like this, and Christmas, pagan holidays, Christmas, Easter. You know, I said, why would you celebrate Christmas? Christmas is not a commandment of Yahweh. Here, Yahweh is saying, keep my commandments. The Savior said, here, we was reading this in the last broadcast, but Revelations 22, the Savior Himself saying, here, verse 12, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according as his work will be. I am the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Blessed are those who keep His commandments, referring to Him, the Father, Yahweh's commandments, the Ten Commandments. That's what the King James Version says. It says, blessed are those who keep the commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life, may have right to the tree of life, and may enter in through the gates into the city. And then He says, all others, for outside are dogs. Dogs, that is sodomites. You shall not bring the price of a dog or the hire of a whore into the house of Yahweh, Yahweh said. Now, and that word dog, if you'd look it up, it means sodomites. Well, men who commit sexual sins with men or little boys. Let me turn to 1 Corinthians here and read it to you quickly. Now, this was read in the last broadcast, but you need it in your mind. He says in 1 Corinthians 6, if you would write these down and then study them later over and over till you see what the Scripture is actually telling you and what you must do for salvation, because the churches today, you know, Pat Robertson with the 700 Club, he finally confessed that the name of the Creator is Yahweh. Well, that's great. Now, Yahweh says, he who nameth the name Yahweh, let him also depart from evil. But is he keeping the commandments? No. No, the Catholic Church is not keeping the commandments. And yet the Savior is saying here in Revelation, blessed are those who keep His commandments. They're the only ones that have eternal life. All others are cast out. Cast out for the lake of fire. Well, here in 1 Corinthians, he says, 1 Corinthians 6:9, do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of Yahweh? Do not deceive yourselves, neither fornicators, nor God worshipers, nor adulterers, nor men who commit sexual perversion with boys, nor men who commit sexual perversion with other men, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor extortioners will inherit the kingdom of Yahweh. None of them will. They won't be allowed. And your Savior is saying here, blessed are those who keep his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life, may enter in through the gates into the cities, into the great city, Yahweh Shammai. For outside are dogs, that's sodomites, sorcerers, whoremongers, murderers. This is sexual perversion, whoremongers. As the apostle Shaul says, when you commit fornication, that's sex with unmarried. And when you commit adultery, you actually sin against your own body. What did he mean by that? He means that you're taking in something into your body that will cause cancer, cause sickness, disease. You know what causes cervical cancer in women? They want to cut everything out, you know, cut everything out of the woman. They want to cut her breast off because she's getting cancer, born with it, or caused it in her own body. But these are the sins. These sins is what causes sickness and disease in your body. Satan don't want you keeping the Ten Commandments. Satan don't want you keeping the laws of Yahweh. She wants you to practice sin. That's what she told Eve. Be evil like the gods. Read that for yourself in your own Bible. It's Genesis 3, verse 5. And she's saying to Eve, you won't die. Well, this is a lie also. All the prophets and the Savior himself, you know, the preachers are telling you, oh, you have an immortal soul. Well, the Savior said, you better fear Yahweh, who has the power to destroy both body and soul in hell fire. Yes, that's what your Bible says. I'm telling you what your Bible says, and the preachers who are so scriptural illiterate, they don't even know that Christmas is condemned in their Bible. Easter. What on earth does an Easter goddess have to do, Easter goddess of fornication and adultery, by the way, have to do with salvation? It's condemned in your Holy Scriptures. What does worshiping the dead? You know, they deify these dead popes. Did you know they deified the rabbis before that? And the pharaohs before that? That's where Israel, the 12 tribes of Israel, got the worship of the dead from, was Egypt. They practiced worshiping the dead. And they told the people, pray to this saint, this dead rabbi. Pray to this dead Pharaoh. He can answer your prayers. Well, they never did. Even today, you know, the Pope, he goes to Jerusalem and prays to the Wailing Wall, as they call it, and wrote a note and stuck it in the Wailing Wall, and never did get any peace. He's praying for peace. He comes back and he invites Perez to come to the Vatican. And there, they got together and they prayed for peace. Prayed for peace. While they continue in their wars. Did you notice the Pope visits every one of these presidents and every one of these world leaders, and shortly after, war breaks out. Did you ever notice that? They're leaders of the kings of the earth, is what Revelation 17, verse 18, the city that sets on seven hills, look up Rome, you'll find out it sets on seven hills, each one of them named after a different god, the name Catholic itself, it means universal. Do you know what that means? It means they worship all gods. They worship all the gods. Isaiah 65, Yahweh said they spend nights keeping memorials to the dead. They eat swine's flesh, following the priest who eats swine's flesh. Did you know that swine's flesh is breaking one of Yahweh's laws? Yes, Leviticus 11, he tells you, meats that are clean and meats that are unclean. Pork, swine, is unclean. But the Catholic Church says, oh, go ahead and eat it. They also endorse eating rodents. Rodents is also named in that same chapter, Leviticus 11. I was showing a preacher the other day, you know, about the seventh day, and I said, what do y'all hate about keeping the fourth commandment. Oh, we don't hate the, we don't hate it. And then he says, what is it? Well, you know, to me that was kind of strange, but I said, how long did you stay in your seminary where you went to learn to preach? And he said, 4 years. And I said, you never learned the Ten Commandments? And he said, well, I remember the Ten Commandments, but we didn't study Scripture. And I said, what did you study? He said, psychology. Well, you know, that doesn't teach you salvation. Salvation comes from the Holy Scriptures. It's the only book on the face of the earth that promises, if you do this, you will live. You will not die. It's appointed unto man once to die. This is speaking of the second death. You will be given eternal life, in other words. And here the Savior is saying, he says, I come quickly, verse 12, my reward is with me. He says in verse 14, blessed are those who keep his laws, King James Version says his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life. Only those that keep his commandments. Or as 1 John 3, 4 through 8 says, practice. He who practices righteousness is righteous. He who sins transgresses the law. Write that down and read it for yourself in your own Bible. Now he says here in verse 15, Revelation, he says, outside are dogs, sorcerers, whoremongers, murderers, worshipers of God, everyone who professes to love yet practices breaking the law. I, Yahshua, Messiah, the King James Version says Jesus, I, Yahshua, have sent my Moloch to testify these things in the congregation. Well, the Apostle Paul said the same thing. Do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom? Do not deceive yourselves, neither fornicators, nor God worshipers, nor adulterers, nor men who commit sexual perversion with boys. And the Pope says he can't make a decision on that? He can't make a decision on sodomy? Why can't he? He's not following the Scriptures. Why didn't he say, look at 1 Corinthians 6, 9, and 10. That's all he would have had to said. He don't have to judge it. He's not a judge anyway of righteousness. He doesn't even know what righteousness is. But the Christian preachers don't know either. This is what puzzles me so much. Pat Robertson made a confession that the name, yes, he confessed that the name is truly Yahweh, and that it had been replaced in the Scriptures, in the King James Version and other versions, with words such as Lord and God. But that won't get him into that won't bring him salvation. You know, just confessing the name or saying, yes, I know that his name was taken out of the Bible. I know his name is Yahweh. That won't get him salvation. What he needs to do is repent. Repent of sin. That's Acts 3, verse 19. He says, repent and be converted. Be converted to what? To practicing righteousness. So that your sins will be blotted out. Your sins are not even blotted out. Just because you confess the name is Yahweh, that won't blot your sins out. You've got to repent of sin, be converted to practicing righteousness, then your sins will be blotted out. You know, that's also said in the book of Yekiskia. That would be Ezekiel in your Bible, in a King James Version. But in chapter 18, verse 20, he says, the soul that sins, it will die. The soul that sins, it will die. The son will not bear the iniquity of the father, nor the father will bear the iniquity of the son. The righteousness of the righteous will be upon himself, and the wickedness of the wicked will be upon himself. But if the wicked will turn from all his sins that he has committed, and keep my statutes, and do that which is lawful and righteous, he will surely live. He will not die. That's the judgment of Yahweh. This whole chapter is filled with this very thing. In verse 30, he says, repent and turn from all your transgressions, So iniquity will not be your ruin. This is Ezekiel. If you have a King James Bible, read it for yourself. This is the same thing that the Apostle Paul, or Shaul, is saying here in 1 Corinthians 6, verse 10. Nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners will inherit the kingdom of Yahweh. Only those who do the will of Yahweh, keeping the Ten Commandments. Blessed are those, this is Revelation 22:14, blessed are those that keep his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life and may enter in through the gates into the city. Well, I thought everyone surely knew, you know, the Ten Commandments and what the fourth commandment was and so forth. But in Exodus 20, we have the Ten Commandments. And of course, this is what Yahshua was referring to in Matthew 19, verse 17, when he said, if you would enter into life, keep the commandments. That's the King James Version. In Exodus, the 20th chapter, we find the Ten Commandments that Yahweh gave to mankind to show him how to practice, what to practice, where he would be righteous. He says, you shall have no hinder gods at all. The King James Version put that other, no other gods, as if Yahweh was just another god. But the word there, if you look up this word other, actually it means hinder. Nothing, no hinder gods. Those don't worship these gods at all. That I brought you out of God worship. Don't worship any hinder gods at all. They are in opposition against me. You see this in Genesis, the third chapter, where Yahweh says he showed how Satan, the serpent, came to Eve and says in verse 4, and the serpent said to the woman, you won't die. Well, that's the lie, see, that as we just read, the soul, they say you have an eternal soul, you have an immortal soul. Well, of course, it's not so. You don't have an immortal soul. And of course, as Ezekiel said, the soul that sins is going to die the second death. The serpent said to the woman, you won't surely die. Go ahead and eat, for he knows that in the day that you eat thereof, your eyes will be opened, and you will be as gods. You will be as gods, knowing evil. Knowing even evil instead of practicing righteousness, you're going to be practicing evil. Well, this is what we're seeing here. The very first commandment here says, don't have any gods. They're in opposition against me. The second commandment is, you shall not make for yourselves any graved images. If you go to the Vatican, if you go to visit Rome, the first thing you'll start seeing is the statues of their dead people that they call saints and the dead people that they pray to. And of course, in Isaiah, let me show you here, Isaiah 65, we see these memorials to the dead. You know, practice of worshiping the dead, they had a holiday for each dead pope, each dead rabbi, each dead pharaoh, and they became so many that it was like this, they were off duty, off work, you know, to worship this god. It was a holiday, and they said, we got to change this, there's too many of them. So they changed it and started, and they made one day to worship all the dead saints. And they called it All Saints Day. Well, that's Halloween. And of course, this is what we see here in Isaiah 65. In verse 2, Yahweh says, I have spread out my hands all day to a rebellious people who walk in a way which is not righteous after their own thoughts. After their own thoughts, their own doing. Yahweh says, you know, that these things are evil. They are the practice of worshiping the dead, and they're evil. And of course, they provoked they provoke the buying and selling of items, worthless items. You know, they have all kinds of trinkets that you can buy, you know, to say, I've been here, and they have colored eggs that they say the bunny laid in the field. It's all based on lies. But Yahweh says, I have spread out my hands all day to this rebellious people who walk in a way which is not righteous after their own thoughts. A people who provoke me to anger continually to my face. Verse 4 says, who assemble and spend the night keeping memorials to the dead, who eat swine's flesh, and the broth of abominable things is in their vessels. That is actually their blood vessels. The broth of, trichna and the eggs of the worm that lives in pork are in their vessels. And by the way, they go to all places in your body. They can, and they even to the brain. And in, sometimes it takes a few years, but they start calling it things like dementia and things like this. But this is poison that comes from, that poisons your body from doing things that Yahweh tells you not to do. Same thing comes with the illegal sex. Yahweh tells you not to commit fornication. He tells you not to commit adultery. Don't defile yourself with it. He tells you don't lie with a man as you would with a woman. Don't have sexual relations with a man as you would with a woman. He said this is confusion. It brings confusion. Well, that means it affects the mind. These things put STDs in your brain, in your body that passes on to your brain, like eating unclean food. Yes, unclean food, the trichna, and the eggs of the worm that lives in pork. It can actually get into your brain. And of course, when it does, it starts causing trouble after a while. Look at verse 5. Who say, stand by yourself, do not come near me, I'm holier than you. Notice there are religious people, but they're doing these crazy things like eating pork and worshiping the dead. Ecclesiastes says, the living know that they will die, but the dead know not anything. Well, of course, it's like praying to the rock wall in Jerusalem. You know, the Wailing Wall, as they call it, like praying to a brick wall. I mean, they can't hear you. When they go to the tomb of Mary, you know, I noticed that the rabbis, they will go and start praying to this brick tomb that they got bricked up there where they say that Mary was buried. Now, they want you to believe that's Mary, the mother of Yeshua. And of course, that may be where she was buried, but Mary, the mother of Yeshua, is dead and buried, and of course, she knows not anything at this time. She will be resurrected. The dead will be resurrected. They've turned to dust now, and of course, Ezekiel is the one that shows that the body of bones, showing you that they will be resurrected, and the flesh put back on them, and then they will be given 100 years to live. Well, of course, here he says, I am holier than you. It shows that this is a religion that's doing this. And verse 7 says, your iniquities and the iniquities of your fathers together. They both practice it, iniquity. And of course, Matthew 24 and verse 12, I believe it is. Let me turn there and read it to you. But Matthew 24, if you got a book of Yahweh, verse 12 says, 24 verse 12, it says, because iniquity abounds, the love of many will grow cold. So this too affects your mind, iniquity. Well, back to the commandment now. He says, you shall not take the name of Yahweh, the Heavenly Father, to bring it to naught. For Yahweh will not hold him guilty that brings dishonor upon or profanes his name. So if you name the name of Yahweh, you've got to depart from evil. That's what Yahweh tells you to do in order to be saved. If you don't name the name of Yahweh, you won't be saved. And if you don't keep his laws, you won't be saved. Remember that. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. This is the fourth commandment. Notice it's the seventh day. Verse 9 says, 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of Yahweh, your heavenly Father. In it you shall do no work, you nor your wife, nor your sons, nor your daughters, nor your maidservant, manservant, and so forth. For Yahweh in 6 days made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that in them is. That is what the name means. He who creates. Yes, he who makes everything. The sea, and all that in them, and rested the seventh day. Therefore Yahweh blessed the Sabbath day, which is the seventh day, and made it holy. Now, of course they say, well, Jesus did away with the law, with the Sabbath. But that's not true. They said he rose on Sunday. That's not true either. In fact, when Mary and the other women came to the grave where he was buried, as it was beginning to dawn towards the first day of the week, he was already gone. But they say, well, we keep Sunday because he rose on Sunday. Well, that's not the reason they keep Sunday. The reason they keep Sunday is it's in honor of the sun god Baal. The same reason they keep Christmas on December the 25th. It's the birthday of the pagan god Baal. Yes, which means Lord, by the way. So you got Baal, which they call Lord or the Lord. And of course, both of them are being worshipped. Sunday, when they came to the grave, it was only dawning towards the first day of the week. It wasn't the first day of the week. Write in and ask for a free booklet on Easter, the true story of Easter, and you'll get a great surprise what your Bible said. Well, here in Matthew 24, he shows that iniquity will abound in this time period, in this generation, and the love will grow cold in this generation. Well, that's what you're seeing right now. You're seeing sin abound. People are confessing that the name is Yahweh because they're wanting people to come to their churches. Did you know churches are closing their doors? Yes, there's a huge amount of people. They say that I just read an article yesterday. A huge amount of people is leaving the churches because they have no answers for their problems. Their prayers aren't being answered. We got drought everywhere. We pray for rain. We get $400 million worth of hail damage, and tornadoes are increasing like crazy. Earthquakes are increasing like crazy. And they go to the preacher, what do we do? Well, he puts a sign up in front of the church saying, pray for rain. Well, I thought he was the one that was supposed to pray for rain, but apparently his prayers are not being answered. Well, why aren't your prayers answered? You're told in Isaiah 59, the first two verses, why your prayers are not answered. Read it for yourself, Isaiah 59, 1 and 2, and call me. The house of Yahweh was established according to prophecy. Isaiah 2:2 said, in the last days I will establish my house. Micah 4 verse 1 says, in the last days I will establish my house. In the last day. The Savior said in Matthew 24 verse 33 and 34, that's the last generation. His house was established in the last generation, along with the nuclear bomb, which started in 1934. Along with the increase in knowledge, which started in 1934, along with my birth, which was 1934. All of it came together to establish the work of Yahweh. Until next broadcast, may Yahweh bless your understanding.